pivoting data. In Excel, the four sections of a pivot table include the filter, rows, values, and columns. In R, we would use the functions filter, group by, summarize, and spread. So let's see how we can use some of these pivoting functions in R. In a new script, let's first load up the Tidyverse library. Control enter to send that to console. And now let's load up a sample data set. You'll be able to find this file in the example files that come with this course. Let's assign it to a new data set called DT. And use read CSV. Make sure we're using the one from the readr library. My data is sitting under raw data. I can hit tab to help me complete this. And the file that we want to load is called employeeDataProcess.csv. So I'm just going to hit tab to complete that and control enter to send that to the console. So let's take a quick look at what this data looks like to be able to see how we want to be able to pivot this data. To do that, I'm going to type in glimpse DT to get a preview. Control enter, just make a console window a bit bigger. So here we can see that we have 118,000 observations with 13 variables or 13 columns. We have a number of character columns. These are probably going to be good for grouping, as well as some double and integer columns, which are generally going to be metric columns that we'll want to summarize. So let's first take a look at this column over here, county. Let's say we want to do a quick count to see how many records we have in each county. We can do that by first starting with our dataset, DT, and piping that into group by, county, pipe, add a new line over here, and we are going to do a count. If I hit control enter to send that to the console, we can see we have 58 different counties, and this column over here, N, basically shows us how many are in each. One thing that would be quite useful is to sort this in descending order so I can see which county is my biggest county. If I come back over here, I can pipe these results into a range and then descending N, which was the name of our count column. Control enter. And I can see that my biggest county is Lewis and Clark. Let's use this value to now filter on. So I can go DT, pipe, filter, county, equals, remember the double equal signs, in quotes, Lewis and Clark. So if I just hit control enter on this, we can see our data has now been filtered on Lewis and Clark, where we have 52,000 records. Right now with all of our columns. Let's do another summary of this by piping this again into group by. This time I'm going to group this by department. And let's do a summary. So let's do summarize. And here, I'm going to look at the annual base, and I want to get the average, the median, and the total. So to do that, I'm going to come over here, make this window bigger. You're going to type in average base is equal to, and in R, instead of the word average, we're going to use the word the function mean. And I will type in here annual base. If I want to summarize another column, I hit a comma. And I can type again median. And these are basically the aliases for what I want my columns to be called, is equal to median annual base. Now it's quite handy that some of these features, these functions are available. For instance, median is not a function that you can find in Excel pivot tables. Total base is equal to sum of annual base. So if I run all that, I can see that I've got my grouping by department, and I have my three metrics for base summarized using an average, a median, and a sum to get the totals. Now, there's quite a few more metric fields that we have available in our data set. So what if we wanted to summarize all of them? To do that, we could use the summarizeIf function. Let's take this first half of our function that we have here. And instead of summarize, this time I'm going to type in summarize, and we can see that there's a few different variants of the function here, and I can use summarize if. So here I can specify something like is.numeric. This will perform an operation on all of the numeric columns. So I could do an operation like sum, right? And that's going to give the sum of all of these columns for me. You could very easily also change this to any one of the other functions like median to get those results as well. Finally, let's take a look at how we can do a row and column grouping, similar to how we do how we'd use the rows and columns in Excel. So to do this, I am going to start with this first bit of my statement again. This time, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take, I want to put department in my rows, and I want to put years in my columns. I'm going to do a summary, which is going to be the total base, which is equal to sum of annual base. And if I just ran this right now, you can see what I get is all the combinations of departments and years, and the total base for those groupings. What I want to do now is take the years and transpose them to get them to run across the columns. To do that, I'm going to pipe this into the function spread. Here, I'm going to type in year, which I want to send across the columns, followed by my metric, which is called total base. Hit Control Enter. And then we can see our pivot. This has been a lecture from my course, R Reporting and Analytics for Excel Users.